Welcome to Home Comfort Tactics, where we uncover the hidden truths about home energy efficiency. I'm Eric Gans, your host and certified energy auditor, here to help you understand how your home could be working against you. Today, I am with Teresa. She recently inquired about how to solve her home comfort problems. Specifically, her family room is super drafty and cold. She saw my YouTube video about replacement windows versus air sealing, which made her question everything she thought she knew. I asked her if she would join me for an episode all about physics and windows, and she agreed. Hello, Teresa, and thank you so much for joining me.
You're welcome, Eric. Thank you for having me and taking the time to unravel this mystery. It's pretty simple. Whenever I sit near the window, I feel cold. What else could be the problem?
Here's the big break in the case that you need. Windows only account for roughly 10% of a home's air leakage.
Wait, only 10%? That's surprising. I always thought windows were the main culprit when it comes to drafts.
You're not alone. That's precisely what most people think, and it's why so many rush to replace their windows. But I have a much different perspective. I used to be a window contractor. Nowadays, I am a certified energy auditor. Talk about being on both sides of the coin.
So if windows aren't the main problem, where are all these drafts coming from?
Teresa, that's the million-dollar question. Today, I am challenging you and my listeners to think about your home in three dimensions. Today, you must stop looking only side to side to solve your comfort problems. Today, you must start to look up and down. Because, in my opinion, it all boils down to the stack effect. Let me ask you this. Do you remember when you learned about hot air rising?
Sure. I remember learning that when I was very young and I saw a hot air balloon.
Exactly. Here is what you didn't learn when you became a homeowner. When warm air rises in a house, pressure at the ceiling builds up, and it escapes through gaps and cracks you cannot see from inside because we like our homes to be finished with drywall, trim, and coverings.
That is, like, the big secret in all of this. You gotta let your mind travel past the ceiling, exactly like the air flows past it, and then work backward to understand where that is happening. And I can assure you that there are many places to discuss. And here's the kicker. Air that escapes gets replaced. So warm air that rises up and goes into the attic is replaced with cold outside air from lower parts of the house, like the basement or crawl space.
So it's like our houses are giant chimneys, constantly circulating air?
Exactly. The stack effect is also called the chimney effect. And it is this vicious cycle, as I like to call it, that is responsible for those cold breezes and cold spots, despite the heat running all day. That is why the top and bottom of a house are way more important to seal than the sides. Everyday things you walk right by, such as recessed lights in the ceiling, open dampers on exhaust outlets, and gaps around the foundation, are low-cost opportunities that can cut drafts much more drastically than replacement windows.
Wow! So the warm air escaping is like the smoke, and the cold air entering is like the fire consuming oxygen.
You are a super fast learner, Teresa.
So, what other surprising draft sources do you find?
Well, crawl spaces are a big one. If you have an open crawl space with vents in the foundation, you're basically inviting cold air into your home. And here's something interesting. Those vents that we think are helping to keep the space dry, they often do the opposite. In more humid areas during the warm months, they can actually make your crawl space a breeding ground for insects and moisture.
That's kind of gross, actually. So what's the solution? Do we need to seal up everything and live in airtight bubbles?
Good one, Teresa. Not quite. A significant first step is to get a comprehensive home energy audit. An audit includes a blower door test, which can help pinpoint where drafts are coming from.
A blower door test? That sounds intriguing. How does it work?
So, picture this. We set up a powerful fan at the front door. It is designed to pull the air out of your house. Since houses leak air, and because of basic physics, for every little bit of air that leaves through the fan, it is replaced by the air from outside,
turning your whole home into a giant vacuum cleaner, sucking air in through every crack and crevice. This exaggerates air leaks, making them easier to detect. And that is where the magic starts to happen for people that see this in real time. They are always blown away by how much air can pass from the attic through a recessed light. Although there are many other places the ceiling connects to the attic, this is a great example that is hiding in plain sight. It gives more meaning to the idea that heat rises and escapes into the attic. The fan shows us where the holes exist by pulling air through them, but remember, due to the warm air rising and the presence of these holes that are now exposed, well, let's just say that your hard-earned money will pass right through and out into the attic, and whether you replace your windows or not. During the blower door test, we can visit windows around the house, and unless a window is partially open or broken in some way, most don't leak that much air, old or new. During the blower door test, people start to get what I'm saying. I can sometimes see my customers' brains sparking up as they connect the dots. It exposes the places where the house they have lived in for so long has actually been leaking air all that time.
That's fascinating. You know, this whole conversation is changing how I think about home energy efficiency. It's not just about windows and doors, is it?
Not at all. It's about seeing our homes as complete systems. And that's really the core message I am trying to get across. We need to stop automatically blaming our windows for draft problems. There's usually a lot more going on behind the scenes, or above and below them, in this case.
Mm-hmm. It's like we've been looking at the wrong part of the house this whole time. Are there any other common misconceptions?
Oh, plenty. One interesting place you might walk right past every day is the rim joist in the basement. It's the board that sits on top of the foundation wall and supports the floor joists. This area is often overlooked, but can be a significant source of energy loss and cold drafts.
I have to admit, I'm not even sure what a rim joist is. But it sounds like another one of those hidden culprits we might not think about when we're feeling a draft.
Exactly. And here's another tidbit. Make sure your windows are fully closed and locked. It sounds obvious, but it's a common issue, especially with new replacement windows that have a top panel that also moves. For those watching on YouTube, check this out. Look at this partially open casement window. Can you hear the rattling? Check out how the partially open window lit up compared to the other when I took an IR image.
You know, the more we talk about this, the more I realize how complex our homes really are. It's like we're living in these intricate machines that we don't fully understand.
That's a great way to put it.
It makes me appreciate the value of experts like you who can help us navigate these complexities. So, what are the key takeaways here?
Well, first and foremost, windows aren't usually the main source of drafts in a home. They only account for about 10% of air leakage. We need to think three-dimensionally about our homes and consider the stack effect, how air moves from bottom to top. Don't forget about any gateway to the outside, like fireplace flues and exhaust fans. And crawl spaces and basements can be major culprits when it comes to letting in cold air.
And it sounds like if you're really concerned about drafts, getting a professional energy audit is probably your best bet.
Right. It can help pinpoint exactly where the problems are.
That makes sense. You know, this conversation has certainly changed how I think about my home and its energy efficiency. I might have to go check my fireplace flue after this, and I'll be taking a closer look at my attic and basement. Who knows what drafts I might find lurking there. What does all this mean for home energy efficiency in the future?
That's a great question. We might see more emphasis on whole house systems rather than individual components. And as energy costs continue to rise, there could be more incentives for homeowners to invest in comprehensive energy audits and improvements.
That makes sense. And with climate change becoming an increasingly pressing issue, improving home energy efficiency could play a significant role in reducing our overall energy consumption.
Definitely. It gives each of us a chance to help. It's a reminder that sometimes the most effective solutions aren't always the most obvious ones. And that applies to so many areas beyond just home improvement.
You're right. It's always worth questioning our assumptions and looking at problems from new angles.
Remember, the next time you feel a draft, don't just blame the windows. There might be a lot more to the story. And maybe consider scheduling that energy audit. Thanks for joining us on Home Comfort Tactics, where we're always uncovering the hidden sources to many home comfort problems that can actually easily be fixed. Until next time, keep exploring and questioning the world around you, and stay warm.